Welcome to class 10 of business environment. So today we are going to study something about economic factors. So economic factor consists of your gross domestic product and per capita income. So then we have to study balance of payment. So then various policies are there. So policies regarding fiscal policy, monetary policy, we have already studied in the last class. So in this class, I tell you, or we are going to study about gross domestic product and your per capita income. So what is this gross domestic product? Gross domestic product is nothing but total number or total amount of goods and services that has been manufactured or created in a country. We call it as gross domestic product. So how much goods and services we are going to produce in a country or in a year, we call it as gross domestic product. And the thing is, gross domestic product means when we are going to consider the total goods and services manufactured in the nation in the year, which means this includes only the final goods and the services. Okay, so when we are going to take into consideration the goods and services means only the final goods and services available for the final consumption. So those goods which are intermediated goods, so which goods are used for the raw material in the process, so such goods are not considered in GDP. So here GDP is nothing but how much goods and services, how much final goods and services of what amount you are going to create in a country, so that we call it as gross domestic product. And this gross domestic product and it plays a very important role in determining the level of business activities. Okay, the level of business activities for the growth of business. So the higher level of GDP indicates more production of goods and services and thereby more business activity. So which means when the GDP is more, when the GDP is more means you are going to produce more and more, right? You are going to create or manufacture the goods and services more and more. So which means there will be more business activity. So there are some concepts of GDP. So the concepts of GDP like GNP. GNP is nothing but gross national product. So what does it mean, gross national product? So gross national product includes the income received from the foreign country. Okay. Or we can say, so it is a measures that it measures the monetary value of all the finished goods and services produced by the country's factor of production irrespective of their location. So here we say income received from the foreign countries, which means irrespective of the location, right? So it measures the monetary value of all the finished goods. Monetary value of all finished goods. Monetary value means the income received of all finished goods which are produced in the countries. So which are produced in the country irrespective of their location. And the next is your gross national income. So what is this gross national income? So gross national income means total amount of money which you are going to earn, or the total amount of money earned by the nation's people and business. So it is used to measure and track the nation's wealth from year to year. So how much income you are going to earn, so how much the nation's people are going to earn, the total amount, so that we call it as gross national income. Then the next is your NNP. What is this NNP? Net national product. So net national product is nothing but after deducting the depreciation. So after deducting the depreciation on the fixed capital assets, so what is going to arrive? So that we call it as net national income. Okay, gross national income minus your gross national income minus your depreciation we call it as net national income. So net national product means, so same thing, the product which is going to arrive after deducting the depreciation. Then the next is per capita income. So what is this per capita income? So that this per capita income we are going to have, or we can say we are going to divide by the population. So per capita income is derived by dividing the total population of the country with its national income or GDP. Okay, so we are going to calculate per capita income is equal to national income divided by total population. So since the per capita income is divided by the population, the large number or the large population will lesser the availability of your per capita income. So what happens when the income is divided among the population? So when the income is less, or we can say even though the income is more and the population is more than the income, what happens? You are going to get it very lesser, right? So population, larger population will lesser the availability of per capita income. So even though we are having the large GDP, we are going to have the lesser per capita income due to the large population. So these concepts which are there, so it may be gross national income, gross national product, or net national product, per capita income. So all these things are the concepts. So these concepts are derived on the basis of methods of GDP, so which is popularly known as national income. Then the next is significance of GDP and per capita income to the business. So national income or GDP we call. So play a very important role in promoting the business activity. So it has some significance to business. So national income, higher national income accompanied with the growing per capita income, so can provide the supportive environment for the growth of business. So when there is more national income or GDP, you are going to have a good opportunity or growth in the business. So we can say first is your growth of business leads to growth in GDP. So business growth will lead to GDP growth. So how? So higher level of GDP is an indication of business growth, it says. So GDP is measured in terms of amount of goods and services manufactured in the manufactured, right, which is a business activity. So manufacturing goods and services is a business activity. So GDP we are going to calculate based on how much amount of goods and services we are going to create in the country. So which means how as many goods we are going to produce in the country, so GDP will increase. So higher GDP is an indication of higher level of business and economic activity. So the next is your per capita income opportunity for business growth. So how per capita income will lead to the business opportunity, or how it will influence to the growth of business? So standard of living is there. So standard of living means what? Consumption of comforts and luxuries. So that is depending upon the per capita income. Only when you are going to have income, you are ready to buy, right? So when the income is divided with the large population, or we can say when it is divided with the population, what happens? Each head, per head, how much money you are going to get or how much income you have. So based on that, your standard of living is decided. So higher consumption, more is the requirement of product, right? If your habit is to consume more luxuries, so your requirement for the production, that will increase. So what happens? GDP and per capita income will also be good in the country. So countries with a higher per capita income will offer more opportunities for the business growth. Why? You have more income, right? When you have more income, your standard of living is better, and when your standard of living is better, you are going to we are going to, or your requirement for the product is more and more, so that the GDP, which means the business activity, will produce more and more. The next is sectoral contribution to GDP and business. So when we take the nation, so we are the nations or economy of nations are broadly classified into three sectors. So one is agriculture sector, industrial sector, and the service sector. So higher contribution of GDP. So higher contribution of GDP we see in these two sectors. Which sectors? Industrial sectors and service sectors compared to agricultural sector. So what happens? Higher share of agricultural to GDP is an indicator to the level of economy backwardness. So whatever agriculture is contributing towards the economy is lesser compared to the industrial sector and the service sector. Then the next is removal of economic evils. So increase in the rate of GDP and increase in per capita income, so that will reduce the economic evils. So what are those economic evils? Economic evils are like poverty, population of high rate are the economic evils. So that will affect both developing and underdeveloped economies. So what happens? When the GDP rate and per capita rate is, or it shows in a upward moving or upward way, so what happens? We are going to reduce or minimize these evils, right? To increase GDP and per capita income, it is necessary that business activity should be taken. So when the business activity is been undertaken, what happens? Your economic evils like poverty, population, or high population rate will reduce. Then the next is determined business policies. So what is this determined business policies? GDP and per capita income analysis helps the organization to promote new business venture and plan business activities and plan business activities. So here GDP and per capita income will help you to plan the business activities. So how it is helpful? So higher share of GDP from the industry and the service sector indicates the level of amount developed and growth of business. Okay. So here, in which industry or in which sector we can contribute more? So we can say industrial sector and the service sector. So what happens? You are going to plan more there. So which is the backward compared to both? Agricultural sector. So we are going to try to come out with the best, or we can say we can come out, or we can improve the agricultural sector. So it says that large number of MNCs are moving towards India to exploit their business potentials, right? So due to this, what happens? We have agricultural industries and service sector, and so far industrial sector and service sectors, they are ready to, or they contribute better to the economy or GDP. Agricultural sector is somewhat backward. So business plan, you are going to prepare such business policy so that we can also come out with a good GDP from the agriculture. Thank you.